Hello everyone and welcome to lecture number 9. In the last lecture we have seen three types of junctions, that is H-plane T junction, E-plane T junction and hybrid T junction. Okay. Now in today's lecture we are going to see directional couplers. We are going to see directional couplers. Now, for what purpose these directional couplers are being used? Okay. Now, let us have an example, or let us assume that we have a waveguide. Okay. This is nothing but a waveguide. Okay. It will be something like this. Okay. We will have this kind of waveguide. Okay. Dash, 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 dash. Of some length. Let us say this is a kind of waveguide of some length. Okay. Now, if we want to measure power or voltage or current I, if we want to measure some of the quantity, okay, then what can be done? How we can measure the signal from in between the waveguide? There has to be some external or some extra connection through which you can measure the power, or you can measure the amplitude, or you can measure the standing voltage, standing wave ratio, VSWR. Okay. So there has to be some option. There has to be some arrangement. There has to be some arrangement over here. Over here, there has to be some arrangement through which the power in between the waveguide can be measured. Okay. And for that purpose, directional couplers are used. Directional couplers are used. Now, let us see the symmetric diagram of a directional coupler. Then how it will be looks like. The symmetric diagram will be, we will have this kind of waveguide. Okay. This kind of waveguide will be there. Over here, you will have port 1. This is port 1. This is port 3. Over here, you will have port 2. Over here, you will have port 4. Okay, you will have four ports, four port network. This is the directional coupler. It's a symmetric diagram of directional coupler. Okay, and in between them, you will have connection like this. Okay. Further, you will also have such kind of arrangement, right? You will have such kind of arrangement. And now you will have a signal moving in this direction. Okay, signal is moving in forward direction, and some part of the signal is coupled to port 4. Okay, and very small amount of part will be going through port 3. Okay, so the upper are known as upper two ports are known as primary waveguides. Okay, and these two are secondary. These two are secondary waveguides. Okay, this one is port 1, this is port 2, this is port 3, and this is port 4. This is the schematic diagram of directional coupler. Okay, directional coupler. Remember, port 1 is directly coupled to port 2. The port 1 will be having a direct relation with port 2. Okay, all the signal, the wave coming in port 1 will be directly going to port 2, but they will be coupled to port 4. Some part of the signal will be coupled to port 4, and port 3 will be isolated, even though some part will be reflected there. Okay, now directional couplers are flanged built-in waveguides. Those are built-in waveguides assemblies which can sample a small amount of microwave. Remember, this is the flow of signal from port 1 to port 2, and we are taking small part of the signal to port 4 for sampling purpose. Okay, small amount of microwave power for measurement purpose. Directional couplers are assembly of waveguides which are being used or which can measure a small part of microwave power. Small part, remember, this is a small part. Okay, this is the last part which is being transferred from port 1 to port 2. Okay, that is why those two are primary waveguides. And small amount of part will be transferred to port 4, coupled to port 4. Okay, for measurement purpose. Okay, now for measurement kind of purpose, you can have power measurement, you can have voltage measurement, you can have voltage sending wave ratio, you can find out the reflection coefficient. Okay, all those things. Now there are some properties, and those are that portion of power traveling from port 1 to 2, but not port, it will travel from 1 to 2 but will not travel to port 3. Okay, all power will travel to port 1 to port 2, but it will not travel to port 3. Okay, similarly, port 3 is the isolated one. This is the isolated one. Remember, this is the isolated one. Similarly, portion of power traveling, if we think the vice versa, the reverse of it, if this is an input, then everything will go to port 1 and some part will be going to port 4, and this will be isolated. Okay, so it can work in bi-direction. Okay, it can work in bi-direction. Now what we want to see is we have directional coupler dictating powers. You will have directional coupler dictating power. Okay, the powers are nothing but, this is the received power. That is a P of R, and this is the port 4 is coupled power. And that is nothing but P of C, that is forward power, P of F. Okay, this is the incident power. Port 1 is incident power. And port 3 will be back power. Okay, so these are the some of the power names: P of I, P of B, which is being given to the ports. Okay, so incident port will have incident power PI. The port which is directly receiving all the power is port 2, and it's having the received power PR. Some of the portion of this signal is coupled to port 4. Some of the portion of this signal is coupled to port 4, and that is known as coupling power. That is PF or forward power. Okay, PF is nothing but forward power, coupling power or forward power. And if you have a reflection, if you have a reflection in between these waveguides, then that is been given to port 3. That is been given to port 3, and that is been known as back power. That is known as back power. Okay. Now we will see some of the properties. We will see some of the definitions and properties of the directional couplers. That is, the first is the coupling factor. Coupling factor C, okay, that is the coupling factor. We will see the definition. Coupling factor of a directional coupler of a directional coupler is usually defined as the ratio of the incident power PI to the incident power PI to the forward power. Okay, in dB, that is also in dB, decibel. Okay, so if we write the formula, we will have C is equals to 10 log PI by PF dB. Okay, that is PI by PF, or you can also write P1 by P4, that is PI is related to port 1, PF is related to port 4, okay. So this is nothing but the coupling factor. Now similarly, we will have another definition, that is directivity, okay. Directivity capital D. Okay, the directivity is defined as the directivity of a directional coupler is defined as the ratio of forward power to the back power Okay, that is P D, and if you write the equation, then capital D is equals to 10 log F by P D. Okay, in dB, that is in decibel. Okay, that is in decibel, right? Now we'll see the third definition, that is isolation. That is isolation. Okay, isolation is related to the incident power and back power. We will see isolation. Okay, it is defined as the ratio of, it is defined as the ratio of incident power EI to the back power. Okay, that is PB to back power PB, and it is being written as I is equals to 10 log E of I by E of B, that is in dB. Okay, so PI is related to port 1 and PB, this is related to port 3. Okay, this is related to port 1 and this is related to port 3. Okay, so the power ratio of P1 by P3 is nothing but isolation. Okay, similarly you will have coupling factor and directivity. Okay, so this is all about the directional coupler. So the next topic is isolators. Okay, the next topic is isolators. Okay, the next topic is isolators. Now first of all, let us understand that what is isolators and for what purpose they are being used. Now if we imagine that this is a waveguide and this will be the load. Okay, this will be the load. Okay, load or any circuit over there, this is the waveguide. This is the waveguide. Okay, and over here we will have the generator, microwave generator. Okay, this is the microwave generator. Now we all know that a signal will be traveling from this point to this point, and if we have a mismatch, right, if we have the mismatch in the impedance, okay, so the characteristic impedance is not matching with the load, then we will have a reflection. We will have a reflection. We will have this kind of reflection. Okay, this wave is going in this direction, this is coming back, this is coming back with the reflection. Okay, now this reflected ray, this reflected ray will create a number of problems for the microwave generators. Okay, this is microwave generator. This can deteriorate. This reflected wave can deteriorate or can decrease the performance of this generator. Okay, it will decrease Okay,
Reflected wave will reduce the performance of a generator. It will have number of, it will try to create number of problems. Now, what will be the solution for this is, what we want is, we want that we will insert some device. We will insert some device in between the generator, in between the generator and load, which will not allow the reflected ray to pass through. It will be grounded, it will be stopped over here. It will, which will not allow the reflected wave to reach to the generator. And this is known as isolators. This device are known as isolators. Okay? Isolators are nothing but the devices, microwave devices, which will isolate the load or isolate this part of the microwave portion to the generator part. It will not allow the reflected wave to go back. Okay? To go back. So if a wave is going in this direction, then it may reflect back, but over here it will be stopped. Over here it will be stopped. It will not be able to go back. It will not be able to go back. Okay? This will not go back. This will go in front direction. Okay? If an isolator is being inserted in between the generator and load, it will stop the reflection. Okay? So it will try to work as an impedance matching device. Okay? It will not generate the mismatch in the impedance mismatch. Okay? It will not generate the impedance mismatch. Okay? Now, let us see that what will be the schematic diagram of isolator. Okay? The schematic diagram of isolator. There are a number of things that is going to be used in isolators, and let us see what is that. Okay? So this is the schematic of isolator. Okay? This is, this part is the schematic of isolator. Okay? This is isolator. Okay? This is isolator. Now, you can see we have port 1. We have port 1 and port 2. We have port 1 and port 2. Remember, transverse electromagnetic wave cannot travel in waveguide. We have derived that formula. Okay? TEM wave cannot travel through the waveguide. There has to be TEM wave or TE wave. Over here we are using TE wave. Remember, over here we are using transverse electric wave. Okay? When a transverse electric wave is being inserted, or first of all let us see, the schematic diagram, or we can say the construction, or we can say the construction of the isolators. Remember, this is the triangular waveguide, and this is the circular waveguide, and again this is a triangular waveguide. Remember, this is triangular waveguide, this is circular waveguide, and again this is a triangular waveguide. Okay? So isolators are combination of rectangular waveguides and circular waveguides. This is rectangular waveguide, this is a circular waveguide, you can see, and this is again a rectangular waveguide. Okay? Remember, isolators are nothing but the combination of rectangular waveguide and rectangular waveguide and circular waveguide. It is being intentionally matched in such a way that it will only allow this forward ray. Okay? It will not allow this ray. It will not allow the backward. It will not allow the backward ray. Okay? It will not allow the backward ray. You will see that how it is working. Okay? Now, you can see one another term, that is this resistive card. This resistive card. You can see the resistive card. You have two resistive cards. Okay? These two are resistive cards. These two are resistive cards. Okay? These two are resistive cards. Now remember, what is the function of a resistive card is? If a resistive card is being placed and you have, this is the resistive card. This is a resistive card, and if you have a electromagnetic wave going perpendicular, see, the polarization of this is perpendicular, okay? The polarization of this is perpendicular. This is this kind of polarization. Okay? It is perpendicular polarization. It is perpendicular to the resistive pad. You can see that is perpendicular to the resistive pad. If the polarization or its transverse is perpendicular, then it will allow to pass. If it is parallel, then it will not allow to pass. If this ray, this wave, this polarization of transverse electromagnetic wave is parallel to the resistive pad, it will not allow to pass. It will dissipate or it will absorb the wave. Okay? Now, so that is the function of resistive pad. Okay? Now, one more thing which has been noticeable over here is, you can see a 45 degree shift. You can see a 45 degree shift in this portion. Okay? You can see 45 degree shift of this portion between the rectangular waveguide and circular waveguide. Okay? Between the rectangular waveguide and circular waveguide. What is the purpose of this is? The purpose of this is, you can see this is the transverse electric, this is the transverse electric, okay? This is the transverse electric. It will provide 45 degree shift to the polarization. It will provide 45 degree shift in this direction, okay? It will provide 45 degree shift. You can see, okay? You can see it is providing 45 degree shift to the polarization in that direction, okay? Now, after that, you have a ferrite rod. This is a ferrite rod. Okay? This is a kind special kind of ferrite rod. Okay? And that will give 45 degree Faraday rotation. Towards this side. It will provide rotation in this direction. This will provide rotation in this direction. So 45 degree in this, and again 45 degree in the opposite direction. So we will get a straight. We will get a straight line. Again 45 degree to in this direction. We will get a straight line, and that will be passed. As this will be perpendicular, this will be perpendicular. Okay. This will be perpendicular to this. The resistive pad will allow to pass. Through port 2. Okay. Now, very important thing. We will see the reverse path. And that is not being allowed. We will see that why it is being not allowed. Okay. Okay. Now, we have completed this part. Now we will see this part. Okay? We have completed this forward part. Now we are interested in this port 2 and moving them in this direction. Okay? Now you can see that when the wave is moving in this direction, due to this Faraday rotation, we will have a 45 degree shift. Okay? We will have a 45 degree shift in this direction. This is the normal. The dashed line is nothing but the normal. Okay, dashed line is nothing but the normal. You have 45 degree shift in this direction. Okay, so you can see 45 degree shift in this direction. Now, very important thing. Due to this 45 degree shift twist. We can say twist. Due to this 45 degree twist in the joint in between the rectangular and circular waveguide, this will have another 45 degree shift. Okay? This will have another 45 degree shift. So, finally, what we will get is this kind of polarization, that is 90 degree. And remember, this is actually parallel to the resistive card. This is actually parallel to resistive card. This is totally opposite to this. This direction is totally opposite to what it has been inserted, okay? It is parallel to resistive card. It will be in this direction, okay? This coming wave will be in this direction. Due to this polarization, this whole electromagnetic wave is being dissipated, it is being absorbed by this resistive card. So it will be absorbed and it will be dissipated inside the resistive particle. This hole will be absorbed. So this is not allowed. Means this direction is allowed while this direction is not allowed. Okay? The reverse direction is not allowed. Okay? So this is all about the operation and working principle of isolators, which is been used to match the impedance between the generator and loads or to stop the reflection of waves through waveguides. Okay? So this is all about the isolator. Okay? Thank you.